good morning everybody, and welcome to another video. So I made a bit of a mistake this morning, and I've done something that I always tell people, or have told people in the past, not to do, and that is to build up my expectations. I checked the weather forecast, and the forecast predicted low cloud, mist and fog. But you can see over my shoulder, that's where I'm going. Blue skies, crystal clear, and excellent clarity, which is not good. So now I'm kind of like heading to my location, heading out on my photo shoot at the beginning of the day. I'm heading out with a negative attitude, disappointed, and that's not good. Something quite eerie about being in a remote woodland when it's dark by yourself. Normally it's something I enjoy, but if you let your imagination get a little bit carried away with itself, you start to freak yourself out a little bit. Let me tell you, do not believe in ghosts. But I can't help feeling there's like a black shadow watching me. So as I'm walking through the woods, I'm sort of glimpsing through the trees to the distant kind of hills and fields beyond. And it looks like I am surrounded by mist and fog. But I'm on a hill, and that hill is like an island. And it seems that the fog is not going to come up and penetrate that hill. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to send the drone up and have a quick look and see if I am in fact surrounded by mist and fog. And if I am, it might be worth dropping down and going on a bit of an explore. And, well, quite frankly, chase the mist. Not sure that's necessarily good advice. But, you know, on paper, this looked like the best conditions for woodland photography. In reality, I'm faced with the worst conditions, which is bright blue skies and sunshine, which is what it will be in about half an hour. Right, get the drone up. Okay, so had a very, very quick look. You know, we're not getting any professional drone footage here. The mist is close and it's actually coming in now, so I'm getting quite excited. And I've brought the drone home. Here we are. Okay, so that was a waste of time. So mist is very much like light in that it can come and go incredibly quickly. It's very elusive. Already it's just dissipating. The frustrations of a landscape photographer. On the plus side, the colours are looking great. I have come out of the woods behind me and into the open field. I am surrounded by a giant wall of fog. It's just not coming this way. My tactic is desperately straightforward. I see the fog, I see the mist down in the fields, down in the valley, and I'm walking towards it. So I've got my camera in my hand, resting under my arm, and I'm operating a gate, and I've got a big bag on and I don't think I can fit. Yes, I'm now on a bit of a wild goose chase. So I'm kind of torn here. I'm torn. I am but 20 yards from the road, and that's a small side track which comes off of the main road, the big motorway, which is only 50 yards behind you. And then over on the other side of the river, which is, there's a river just here on the other side of the river, some train tracks. It's very noisy, very industrial, very chaotic, but there is this tiny, tiny solitude, this small piece of woodland that I'm stood in now. I'll be honest with you, I do not think this image would work without the benefit of the mist. It's the mist that gives everything mood, atmosphere, mystery, and, you know, it's photographer's worst kept secret that mist makes everything so much easier and better. And it's true, it really is. So the scene that I'm shooting now, just behind me, it's very simple and it's only made possible by the conditions. And we have this tree here, which is my main focal point, my main area of interest, with the vines twisting around the tree and the side light from the brighter sky that you can just see up there, and it's fantastic. And then with everything falling off into softness in the background, it just makes a very nice, quiet, peaceful image. Now this tree has a couple of assets, a couple of benefits. One is obviously the vine leaves that are running up the side of it. There's also a nice branch peeling off to the right hand side, which adds balance to the scene. And finally, in the distance, about 50 yards past the tree, there is a prominent dark tree which sits relatively close to the center of my frame. But all of that is pulled together by the light that's spilling in from the top right corner and the mist that softens everything. So with the light flooding down and the mist washing everything out, it just looks incredibly dreamy. So I think I'm gonna call this video The Work of a Desperate Photographer. Because man, this is, you know, I enjoy a peaceful shoot, well thought out shoot. I am driving roads I don't know in areas I've never been to. And I've just driven past a fantastic image, but let me tell you, it's a single track road. There is absolutely nowhere to stop. So it's gonna have to be a run and gun job. I'm gonna have to stop in the middle. I mean, it's a flipping empty, completely isolated, empty road, but I'm gonna have to stop in the middle of the road. And I'm gonna have to jump out, grab the shot handheld, get back in. But I think it's worth it. Wait till you see it. It's just the woodland, you know, just the road passes by a little section of woodland. And it just, oh, all right, give me a minute. We'll grab a quick shot. And yeah. It's good fun. You know, landscape photography comes in many, many different forms. Thank you. So unfortunately, by the time I'd made it back up here to this woodland where I started my photography this morning, the mist had well and truly lifted. And that's a great shame, but there is still some nice light around and some nice opportunities to be had. Although we don't have the mist, the light that is falling in these woods is quite diffused because the mist has lifted and is kind of now turning into this low cloud and the sunlight's just filtering through it. And I found a composition here that just caught my attention. I'm completely undecided as to whether or not it's going to work. But I think whilst I'm here, I may as well make the effort and take one last shot before I go home. So what caught my attention with this scene was these two dominant black arcing trees, but also then behind those two dominant dark black trees, we have these very uniform pencil-like pine trees just catching the light beautifully. And especially with that diffused light, they just shine, you know, it really adds depth and dimension to the image. That's kind of what I'm thinking. It's not perfect, and I'm going to be completely honest with you. There is quite a lot of highlights, distracting highlights within the scene where you can see the bright sky beyond the canopy. Now that is something that I just can't deal with that. So I am going to go in to Photoshop and remove as much of that white canopy as I can. So when you see the final image, you know, there will be some specular highlights that have been cloned out. I mean, it's nothing crazy. I'm just looking at it now. I can see bits of blue sky beyond the foliage. And I think that's a shame. I think all in all, it's a nice little scene and well worth shooting. Yeah, absolutely. Well, I think that's me done. The sun is coming out stronger and stronger, and we're pretty much going to have blue skies. So that's definitely it for today's photography. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Oh, and of course, you can't get away with the video without doing a weekly calendar plug. So my 2021 calendar is available. I'll put a link below. So yeah, get that. Like the video. Do all the good stuff. All right, definitely going now. Bye. 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 Bye.